Welcome to a quick lesson on direct and inverse variation. For direct variation, the following statements are equivalent. Y varies directly as x, y is directly proportional to x, and y equals kx for some constant k. So if we see any of these key words or this key equation, we know we're dealing with direct variation. The number k is called the constant of proportionality. And one more thing we should notice, if we have the equation y equals kx, this would be a line passing through the origin or have a y-intercept of 0, and the slope of that line would be k, the constant of proportionality. In general, if two quantities vary directly, if one quantity goes up, so does the other, and if one quantity goes down, the other also goes down. Let's take a look at an example. The first sentence states that y varies directly with x. And that's extremely important because right away that tells us we're dealing with direct variation stated by the equation y equals kx. Next, we're told that y equals 28 when x equals 7. The reason that's so important is that is going to allow us to determine the constant of proportionality. Let's go ahead and finish the question. It says determine the direct variation equation and then determine y when x equals 3.5. So again, going back to the given information, since we know that y equals 28 when x equals 7, we can now find k. 28 must equal k times x, which is 7. So solving for k, we'll divide both sides by 7. We know that k is equal to 4. So that tells us our direct variation equation is y equals 4x. Now we can determine y when x is 3.5 because y is going to equal 4 times 3.5. So y will equal 14 when x equals 3.5. So there were two questions here. The first question was determine the direct variation equation. That was here. And the second question was determine y when x was equal to 3.5, which we found there. Let's go ahead and take a look at a real world application. Hooke's law states that the displacement d that a spring is stretched by a hanging object varies directly as the mass m of the object. If the distance is 12 centimeters when the mass is 4 kilograms, what is the distance when the mass is 5 kilograms? Okay, so looking at this first sentence, there's a lot of words here, but the most important part is it states that d varies directly as m. So that tells us our direct variation equation will be d equals k times m. Next, it says the distance is 12, so d equals 12 centimeters when the mass is 4 kilograms. Again, what this allows us to do is determine the constant of proportionality or the value of k. Let's go ahead and do that and then we can answer the question. So d equals 12 when m is equal to 4. So now we'll divide both sides by 4. This tells us that k is equal to 3. So that allows us to determine our direct variation equation in this situation, where the distance is equal to 3 times the mass. So now, when they ask us what is the distance when the mass is equal to 5 kilograms, it's going to be d equals 3 times 5. So the distance is equal to 15 centimeters. Okay, let's talk about indirect or inverse variation now. The following are equivalent for inverse variation. We can state that y varies indirectly as x, or y is inversely proportional to x, or y equals k divided by x for some constant k. And in general, if two quantities vary indirectly, if one goes up, the other goes down, and vice versa. Let's take a look at a couple examples of this. Again, the first sentence is very important. It says y varies inversely as x. That's telling us our equation will be y equals k divided by x. The next sentence states y equals 27 when x equals 1/3. We want to determine the inverse variation equation and then determine y when x equals 18. This second sentence will allow us to find k. It says when y equals 27, x is equal to 1/3. So using these values in this equation, we have 27 equals k divided by 1/3. Now there's a couple ways to solve this, but if we put this 27 over 1, we have a proportion where k times 1, that would give us k, must equal 27 times 1/3. Well, multiplying by 1/3 is the same as dividing by 3, so this would be k equals 9. So now we have our inverse variation equation, y equals 9 divided by x. So now we can determine y when x equals 18. Y equals 9 divided by x, but x is 18. So that tells us y is equal to 1/2 when x equals 18. Again, there were two questions here. The first one was determine the inverse variation equation, and the second was determine y when x was equal to 18. What I want you to notice here is that notice when x went from 1/3 to 18, x increased, but y went from 27 to 1/2, so y decreased. Let's take a look at a real-world application now. The time t required to empty a tank varies inversely as the rate r of pumping. If a pump can empty a tank in 45 minutes at a rate of 300 gallons per minute, how long will it take to empty a tank at 500 gallons per minute? Okay, so let's decipher the key information here. Looking at this first sentence, the time t varies inversely as the rate r. That should allow us to write our inverse variation equation as follows. T equals k divided by r. So they often change the variables, but the form of the equation stays the same. Next, we're told that if a pump can empty a tank in 45 minutes, so when t equals 45 minutes, at a rate of 300 gallons per minute, so that's when r is equal to 300 gallons per minute. Again, this information will allow us to determine k. Let's go ahead and do that now. Notice this is both in terms of minutes, so we do not have to do any conversions. So we'll have 45 must equal k divided by r, which is 300. Let's go ahead and put the 45 over 1. We can find k if we find the cross products. K times 1, that would give us k, must equal 300 times 45 is equal to 13,500. So now we can take this general inverse variation equation and write it specifically for this case where t must equal k, which is 13,500, divided by our rate, r. So now the question is, how long will it take, or what will t be, when the rate, or r, is equal to 500 gallons per minute? So we take our equation and replace r with 500. T equals 27 or 27 minutes. Now again, that should make sense because if it takes 45 minutes at a rate of 300 gallons per minute, if we increase the rate to 500, it should take less time, and it does. It went from 45 minutes to 27 minutes. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.